two reasons why, and I'll explain one, and Adam will explain the other one briefly. But just wanted to make sure that you and the American public know, as well as our colleagues in the House know, that we have an active investigation going on. We are pursuing it aggressively. We're pursuing it on a bipartisan basis. And each of the lines that you would expect, whether it's documents, people, whatever the piece may be, we've been pursuing that. As your print folks know, I've been relatively circumspect about my availability, and I will continue to do that because we're going to do the investigation the right way, and I don't need to do it in front of you. In fact, I cannot do it in front of you, but just want to make the American public aware that we do have an aggressive investigation ongoing right now, and we intend to follow every lead, talk to every witness, and get to the answers that all of us, to the questions all of us want answered. So thank you for being here this afternoon. With that, I'll turn to my colleague, Adam.
Mike, thank you. And I just want to join my colleague. We have discussed the desirability of periodically doing status updates to say that we are following up on a number of requests that we have made of witnesses to provide information and testimony to us voluntarily. We fully expect that most of those that we invited will do so. Obviously, as many of you know, at least a couple of the witnesses that we have sought have decided to decline to voluntarily cooperate, so we did issue those subpoenas to them last week, and we will follow up with others. So hopefully we'll secure their voluntary cooperation, but if not, we'll use whatever process is necessary. We're also planning the schedule forward in terms of interviews once we receive the documentation and have a chance to review it. But more than that, we're looking now to what additional open hearings we can schedule. And Mr. Conaway and I have been discussions about one of the next open hearings that we would like to have. We intend to reach out to former Secretary Jay Johnson. We'd love to have him come and testify before us in a hearing that would be both open session followed by closed session. We haven't had a chance yet to communicate with the Secretary, but he has been certainly cooperative in terms of my interaction with him over many years. And I think he would have insight as one of the signatories into that October 7th statement issued by the IC attributing the conduct for the first time by the administration to Russia, as well as interactions that the Obama administration and he had with secretaries of state and local elections officials in terms of the dangers posed to our elections infrastructure by what the Russians were doing. So those are some of the plans we have ahead, but very much have appreciated the opportunity to work with Mr. Conaway, and we look forward to our continued progress on the investigation together.
So we're not going to take questions, but as we complete things that we can share with you, we understand your desire, keen interest in getting that done. As the subpoenas went out, those are completed. We've announced that. So as we complete things, we intend to keep you updated as best we can, and appreciate you being here this afternoon. Thank you.
Have you heard any response to your subpoenas?